Let's take Moore's advice and move away from using histograms. Up to this point, we've looked at distributions of single variables, for example, friend count. And at most, we looked at different subsets of friend count by splitting it using a factor, or in our case, it was gender. Now we're going to look at two continuous variables at the same time. So to get started, make sure you're in the right working directory, and then go ahead and load your dataset and load the ggplot library. Usually, it's best to use a scatterplot to examine the relationship between two continuous variables. Qplot chooses the scatterplot automatically when we pass two continuous variables to the x and y parameters. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll pass age to the x parameter, and I'll pass friend count to the y parameter. And finally, I'll indicate that my dataset is PF, my pseudo Facebook users. Now, there's over 99,000 observations in our data. So when we create this plot, it might take a few moments to render. And there it is. We could also write this code, which will produce the same exact plot. This time, I'm not using the x and y parameters explicitly. And that's okay because qplot knows which variables to use on which axis. X will come first and y will come second. I'll run this code just so that way you can see the same plot being produced. And there we go. We have a pretty ugly scatter plot. But what are some things that you noticed right away?